Hi, welcome back to this series on creating a game in HypeHype. In the last video, we introduced pre-mades and add-ons as an easy way to add gameplay mechanics to your hype. But sometimes, you're going to want to make something that's maybe not available as a pre-made, and in that case, you're going to want to start working with logic nodes. In this video, we'll introduce the basics of working with logic by creating a finish line with some endgame logic for Mr. Moustache's obstacle course. Since we're going to be working with logic again, you're going to want to make sure that you're in the game editor. So what is logic and what are logic nodes? Logic is what's going to make your game work. And logic nodes are the tools that you use in the HypeHype editor to create your own game logic. There's a variety of different types of nodes and each set serves a different purpose. Triggers are all nodes that make stuff happen. Logic are all nodes that are going to use math or numbers in some way. Actions are, well, actions. Joints can connect two physical objects together. Visuals will control visual elements within your game. Meta nodes cover a variety of uses that'll be useful for building different types of systems for your game. Vectors and rotations are both similar to logic in that they use math, but they're a little more complex, handling multiple values at the same time. Audio does audio, color does color, and multiplayer are nodes that you're going to need if you want to create a multiplayer game. Now let's use some logic, but first we're going to need an object to act as our goal area. You can use any object you like. I'm a big fan of these marquee objects as goal areas. They're nice, can be resized, and look like they're marking an area that you want to go to. So we're going to put this here a little bit away from the player. Now there's a few different ways that you can add logic nodes to your hype. First, we'll tap the nodes icon to bring up the node library. From here, we can add any logic nodes directly into our scene. For our finish line, we're going to need a game end, so let's add one right now. Adding nodes this way will bring them into your scene as one of these node icons. These have no visual or physical properties, so you can only see them and work with them in the editor. They're not going to be visible during gameplay. We can also add nodes directly into objects, so let's select our goal area and expand the details panel. If your object doesn't yet have any physical properties, switch it to unmovable object, and then let's hop over to the advanced panel. All objects have a visual and object node, and since we gave this object some physical properties, it also has a physical node. We can add more nodes by tapping the plus icon next to the object node. Our finish area is going to need to detect collisions, so let's add a collision trigger. And it would also be nice if it maybe had a little bit of movement to attract the player's attention, so let's add a simple animation. The new nodes that we've just added have been added to this list in the details panel for that object. We're going to come back to this in a moment, but first, let's add a couple more nodes. Some items from the asset library are going to come with logic nodes with them. Most notably, effects, and we're going to need an effect for our finish line. I like this star explosion. Let's take one of those. We can see here it's come in with a particle effect node. And maybe we also want to add a sound. So we'll go to our sounds here. We'll look for a nice wind sound. There we go. And we can see that sound has come with a sound node. Okay, so now we have enough parts to make a nice little goal area. Let's start to put them together. I'm going to start in the physical node of this object. I'd like the player to be able to pass right through this object, so I'm going to toggle on this sensor option. And that's all I want to do in here. Next, I'm going to look at the collision trigger. Now, the collision trigger works by looking for these different colored object groups. So we need to tell it what color object group to look for. In pre-mades, players are always in the green object group, so we want to look for green. Now that the trigger knows what to look for, we need to tell it what to do when it detects that collision. We can do this by dragging links to the nodes we want to trigger. We can drag directly from the details panel. In this case, I'm going to want to use the on collision start output, so I'm just going to drag from the little triangle right to our game end, and then I'll select execute. Link is done. Okay, now on the most basic level, our goal area should work. Let's give it a test. All right, so it worked, but it was still a little wonky. Let's make it better. So we can also create links by dragging from the little link icon on the object widget. Let's drag from that link icon to the particle effect. Now, when we link this way, we also have to select which output we want to use if the object that we're dragging from has multiple outputs. Again, we want to use on collision start, and with the particle effect, we're going to want to hit executing and on. Now, there's a slight difference in HypeHype between execute and executing. A node that executes is just going to trigger one time at that exact moment that it's executed, whereas a node that has executing is going to execute over time. In this case, our particle effect maybe runs for a little bit of time, probably not a lot of frames, but a few frames, and so the particle effect is going to run for the length of the effect. Let's now also execute our sound node. You can use either linking option you like. On collision start, execute. Now let's give it another test. There we go. Now we got the sound, we got the particle effect. Still needs a little bit of polish though, doesn't it? So let's jump back into the editor and let's make this a little bit better. First thing I noticed is our particle effect is executing right away, and that's because that executing is toggled on. It's just going to toggle that off, and now the particle effect is going to wait for its signal before it executes. Now, some nodes, like the particle effect, can also be targeted to an object. And I would like this particle effect to come from my goal area, not from the particle effect node that's just floating in the air here. So I'm going to drag from this target to my circular marquee, and now the particle effect should come from that object. The last thing I'm going to look at is our marquee was kind of rotating weirdly, and that's from the simple animation that we put in it. So to fix that, we're going to simply change this to rotate around Y. It's going to make it move in a nice round fashion along the ground. And maybe we want to slow it down a little bit. Let's see how that goes. There we go. Now it's a nice slow turn. Particle effect goes, sound goes. Excellent. We have made a finish line. Now there's one last thing I'd like to talk about before we wrap this lesson up. You can see as I started linking here, we get these little lines that are traveling between our nodes. We have a pretty simple logic set up right now, so it's no big deal. But when you get into some more complex logic, you might start having a lot of nodes linking to a lot of other nodes, and you end up with a lot of these lines going all over your hype. One way we can reduce these lines and still allow different clumps of logic to communicate with each other is with broadcasts and broadcast listeners. For example, this empty template that we used started with a game end system already in it. Let's use this instead of the game end node that we added earlier. First, let's inspect the game end system that this template came with. We can see here we have two broadcast listeners, one for success, one for fail, and each triggers a selection of nodes, including a sound, a game end, and a vibration. Each of these broadcast listeners is looking for a specific broadcast signal, in this case, the game success. Let's move back to our finish area and work that into it. So first thing we're going to do is delete our old game end. We don't want this anymore. Next thing we're going to do is add a broadcaster. And in this case, we're going to want this broadcaster to be game success. It was already. Nice. And then again, just like we did before, on collision start, we're going to execute that game success. Now we're using that game success logic from the game end system instead of just a simple game end node that we had earlier. There we go, everything works. Now a few things, it's playing double sounds. Maybe we want to get rid of one of the sounds. We didn't use a ton of nodes here, but it's usually a good idea once you finish a section of logic to grab each node and then tap this little plus icon at the top to collect them all into a container. We can name this container, we'll call it goal area. And we can hide the logic by tapping the little eye icon. Now that you've gotten a basic introduction to logic, I encourage you to play around, play with different nodes, try and figure out what they do. If you need some help figuring out what a node does, you can always tap on this little question mark icon that appears next to the node in the details panel. That's going to open up the wiki entry for that node, where you'll be able to find some information, maybe some video tutorials on how to work with that node. Thanks for joining me for this part of the Making a Game in HypeHype tutorial series. In the next video, we're going to look a little more at containers, as well as working with reusables and editing pre-made logic while we add some hazards to our obstacle course. See you then. Tablet sync. Oh, what the tablet sync? Hi. Already f***ing up. God, it's been so long since I've done pre-recorded. Hi, welcome back to part 4 of this series. Of course, I didn't script this part. In this, I hate this already. By creating a finish line for this obstacle course, logic, by creating a finish line with, in this video, we'll introduce the basics of working with logic used within HypeHype to build the logic that will scrolly scroll. Our goal area is going to need to be able to detect collisions. Now we're using that game success logic instead of the
Thanks for joining me for this part of the Making a Game in HypeHype tutorial series. In the next video, we're going to look a little more at containers, as well as working with reusables and editing pre-made logic, while we add some hazards to our obstacle course.
That's a f***ing long sentence. That was kind of painful. And then one more time.